In this video, I'm going to show you how you can install a web server on the Raspberry Pi 3 and host a website on it, and that too on the internet. So with that being said, let's get straight into the video. Hey guys, it's Steve back with a new video on the channel, and I know it's been long since I've uploaded a video on the channel, but from now weekly uploads are on. So in this video, we're going to install Apache server and PHP on the Raspberry Pi 3, and we're going to host a simple web page on it. And I'm going to show you how to access that web page over the internet, not in the LAN, over the WAN, that is the internet. So yeah, the minimum requirements are a Raspberry Pi, let it be any version, and of course a good internet connection. So yeah, firstly you'll need to install a fresh copy of Raspbian onto the SD card and then plug it into the Raspberry Pi and power it on. So guys, we are here onto a trusted computer, and I've connected the Raspberry Pi to my router via a LAN cable, and I know its IP address. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put up a SSH connection over to the Pi, and I'll get the terminal of the Raspberry Pi, and now we're gonna install the Apache server as well as the PHP via these two commands. So we're gonna do that, and once that is done, we're gonna host our Raspberry Pi's web server onto our internet. So let's just do that. So first we're gonna do SSH into our Raspberry Pi. So let's do that via the PuTTY software. So the default username and password are Pi and Raspberry. I highly recommend you to change that. So yeah, we have SSH into a Raspberry Pi, and first what you'll need to do is you'll need to update your Raspberry Pi by this command, sudo apt get update, and hit enter. So this will update your Raspberry Pi, and once that is done, you are good to use these two commands to install the Apache 2 server and the PHP. So yeah, the update is completed, and now we'll install the Apache 2. So just hit enter. So yeah, Apache is already installed. I have installed it, and this command is for the PHP one. Hit enter. So yeah, once Apache and PHP are installed, you can reboot the device and get an SSH connection again. So let's reboot it. So now we have rebooted the Raspberry Pi and we are good to go. So the web pages or the web application that you want to load onto the Raspberry Pi's Apache server are stored in this directory. So let's get over to that directory. So as you can see, I've already created two sample pages. One is the index.html and one is the info.php. You can go to this directory and extract your WordPress, Joomla, or whatever you want. So I've just created a sample index.html page to show you that this Apache server and the PHP are working. So I'll just show you what's inside that. So that's a simple HTML code that will display "Hi, this is Asit from Raspberry Pi." So now to start the server, Apache 2 server, this is the command, service Apache 2 start, and hit this enter. Yeah, so you just need to provide your identity, hit 1, and the password. Yeah, so now the Apache server is running, and to check it out, you can just go to your browser and enter the local IP address of your Raspberry Pi. So that is 192.168.1.102 in this case. In your case, it might be different. So to check that, you can just download the Fing app on your Android device, and you can just scan your Wi-Fi network to check the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. Just enter. And as you can see, this web page is loaded. Hi, this is Asit from Raspberry Pi. So now our Raspberry Pi is working fine. So the Apache server is working really fine. And let's check for the PHP one, /.php, hit enter. So as you can see, the PHP is also working really fine, and this is working onto our local router. So what we want to do is we're going to put this server onto the internet. So to do that, we need to go to the router's login page, and we need to configure the router, and we need to do port forwarding. So let's just do that. So in most of the cases, your router's login page will be like 192.168.1.1 or 192.168.0.1. So just check these out. If these don't work, then you need to check your router manual to get the admin page of your router. So the default username and password of these are admin and admin. I highly recommend you to change that as well. I have already changed it. So just log in into it. So yeah, once you have logged in into your router's panel, you'll get information like this, where your public IP address will be over here in the WAN section, not in the LAN section. So I'll just copy this, Control C, and I'll just paste it over here to check if it's working or not. I'll just hit enter and see if it's working or not. So it's not working right now because we have not included the port forwarding currently. So we'll just check with the port 8080 as well, on which we are going to do actually. So it's not working right now. So let's switch back and we are going to do port forwarding. So yeah, to do port forwarding, what we need to do is we need to go to the forwarding section, click on virtual servers and click on add new. So here we are going to need the service port. So in this case, we are going to use port 8080. You can also use 80, but my port 80 is currently occupied and it's giving some error. So I'm going to use the port 8080 as the external port. And the internal port will be the port on which your Apache server is running. So that is running by default 80. So we're going to hit enter 80 here. And we're going to need, it's going to need the IP address of our Raspberry Pi, as that will be forwarded. So I'll just enter the IP address of your of the Raspberry Pi. So once that is done, you can give protocol all. Status enabled and just hit on save. Once you hit save, the port has been forwarded and you can just check that same link, that is your public IP address and the port. So in this case, I've given port 8080. You can also give port 80, or if you want to forward the SSH, you can give it 22 and 22 over here. So I'm just gonna hit enter and let's see if it works. So as you can see, it is working really fine and this page has been displayed. Hi, this is it from Raspberry Pi and this is our public IP and that's not our internal IP. So let's check if PHP is working. Yeah, so PHP is also working very fine and that's how you actually forward your port and host your server onto the internet with the help of port forwarding. If you guys enjoyed this video, then please make sure to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. You guys can also press the bell icon beside the subscribe button so that you'll get notified whenever my new video is out on the channel. So thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you in the next one.